Hi everyone, and welcome back to another episode of The Mobs Have Eyes. And yeah, there's a nice little path, a little mailbox, some sort of building there. But today we're going to go over to spawn because I've just been over there and it's a huge big mess. So I've filled up the inventory with like lots of building materials because it's just nasty. Now previously off camera I built a path to spawn just to make it easier because people keep getting lost. And because I have so much wood lying around, well, I just built it out of wood. So here we go for a run. There's all these little islands that eventually hope to get reached to. So just keep running, running. That horse has fallen in the water again. But if you keep falling in the water, I'm going to have to hit you out. Oh no, I fell in the water. Up we go. Should really fill that in at some stage. Through the mountain. I just tunneled through the mountain because it was such a mish to parkour all the way over here. Round through here and up to spawn. Was a hut, so like here, and a building up there. Both have gone. So now we just got like this big, like lava hole, and water, which isn't the nicest. The water is nice. It would probably be a little bit better because the spawn area is kind of, I think, one of those trees. It's where I spawned anyway. So just do something nice and tidy this all up for everyone. Because you don't want to be coming out of your house. I don't know what went on here at all, but we'll just give it a quick tidy up. God, to get everything under there too, so it's just a floating part. Now, though, I did put a double chest over there that had, like, all the goodies in it, some stone tools and everything to help people out when they first started. That somehow got hit as well, so now it's like a single chest. And I think there's only wooden tools left in there. But I'll look at that at some stage. Because I came over one day and put some food in there as well to help out. And then my base got raided and all my food got nicked. And I was like, oh great. Granted, I've got the farms there, which people can just use. As long as they don't kill my animals, because yeah, I kind of want animals. So I can be self-sustaining-ish. But yeah, I don't know what we're talking about. I just came on and I was like, whoa, let's send some messages and see who knows what we're talking about. Didn't hear anything. I can't have been a creeper. It's looking like a big TMT storm or something, but I don't know how that would happen. But you never know, stranger things have happened in the line. So, when I tidy all this up, I'll just do one of those speed montages, I guess. And here we go. Well, that took a lot longer than what I expected, but, yes. That's all done. Welcome to the retirement village. Over here we have my grandpa shack, the garden, some guest accommodation that I put in place, because just in case you're running through and it comes night and you don't want to deal with that, you might want somewhere to stay. I'm guessing this is a dog, I don't know. Reed farm, carrot farm, wheat farm, and that's Eli's house over there. Because I had all this room, he's like, mind if I move in here as well? I was like, yeah, sure. That's good for it. Hello, horsey. Hello. We even have a swimming pool. I'm about to go for a swim. This is where the horse is meant to be, but he ran away. And so I don't have a lead here. It's just our guest accommodation. We offer people something to watch. And chest. There's complimentary snacks, a crafting bench, and a furnace with some coal in it, so it's all there, and a bed. That way they don't have to run to like, my houses or anything like that. And A and B. And yes, so there we go. I'm going to go and feed chickens and have a sleep. And until next time, we'll see you then. Bye bye.